أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على افضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الامين وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة الانعام، اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا معشر الجن والانس، الم ياتكم رسل منكم يقصون عليكم اياتي وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا؟ قالوا شهدنا على انفسنا، وغرتهم الحياه الدنيا وشهدوا على انفسهم انهم كانوا كافرين. ذلك ان لم يكن ربك مهلك القرى بظلم واهلها غافلون. ولكل درجات مما عملوا وما ربك بغافل عما يعملون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم، واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار، واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters and sons and daughters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are beginning with a very important ayah of the Quran regarding its basic philosophy. Ya ma'ashar al-jinn wal-ins, O assembly of the jinnis and the humans, alam yatikum rusulun minkum, didn't come to you our messengers from amongst yourselves, yaqussuna alaykum ayati, relating to you our ayat, our revelations, wa yunzirunakum liqa yawmikum haza, and warning you about the meeting of this day of yours. Qalu shahidna ala anfusina, they will say, yes, we testify against our own selves. وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا, and they had been deceived by the life of the world. وَشَهِدُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, again, and they will be the witnesses against their own selves, أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا كَافِرِينَ, that they had been unbelievers. Now why this bracketing of jinnis and humans in this ayah? In the Quran, there are only very few ayat in which these two creatures, you know, they are grouped together and addressed together. Although we find in Surah Ar-Rahman that about 33 times it is repeated, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Here again, you know, repeatedly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a question from the jinnis as well as the humans. But addressing them together, positively asking them something to do, is very seldom in the Quran. Mostly Quran addresses human beings. Now what is common here between the jinns and the humans that they are bracketed here together? Let it be known that of all the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are only three creations who have self-consciousness. Although the innumerable forms of life on this planet, whether they are on the land or in the sea, they have consciousness. Animals have consciousness. But the self-consciousness, consciousness of his or your own ego, which we denote, I am. This self-consciousness is shared only by three creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels, the jinns, and the humans. Out of these three, the angels are a part and parcel of the unseen. Therefore, there is no question of any testing or trial. They see the heavens with their eyes. They see the hell. So there's no question of any testing or trial. Now these two, jinns and the humans, they are tried here in their lives, whether they believe in the unseen or not. This is the basic test. That is why you find in the Quran, you know, in the absolute beginning, you know, وَذَلِّ الْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. This is the first examination to which both of these have been put. They have to believe in Allah, although they can't see in it. They have to believe in paradise and hell, although they can't see it. They have to believe in angels, although they can't see them. So all this unseen world, to believe in them, through their intellects, through their understanding, through their hearts, that is the first test. And let me quote here a saying of Confucius, a very big Chinese saint and sage, one of the biggest sages and saints of the human history. A very beautiful sentence of his is, there is nothing more certain, there is nothing more real than what cannot be seen, and there is nothing more certain than what cannot be heard. You know this, the realities, real realities, they lie beyond our senses and our perceptions. So this is the first step towards philosophy, wisdom. And this is the first step towards guidance. يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَبِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. يَا مَعْشَرَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَقُصُّونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِي وَيُنْذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا قَالُوا شَهِدْنَا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِنَا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. But they were engrossed, they were lost in this worldly life. The pleasures, comforts, amenities of this world, they deluded them. They keep them involved in them all the time, never having a time to think about the creation. Who created me? Who am I? Where from I have come? Where I am heading towards? What is the end? Is this is the only life from birth till death? Or something beyond it? Zalika. Now what is this Zalika? Why these messengers had been sent? Zalika. Zalika lam yakun rabbuka muhlik al-qura. This is because your Lord was not going to destroy the townships and cities, you know, that he destroyed. Bizulmin. Wrongfully. وَأَهْلُهَا غَافِلُونَ. And you know the people, in a state when the people were not warned already, warned before. Allah destroyed the nations, but after warning, He sent the messengers, He sent Nuh, and He kept on warning His people for more than 900 years. 950 years, as it is given, you know, in Surah Al-Ankabut. He kept on warning. But even then, if people didn't heed to him, pay any heed to him, but they were doomed. So they were warned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not unjust that he would have destroyed them without warning. وَلِكُلِّن دَرَجَاتٌ مِمَّا عَمِلُوا. And for everyone are the ranks, all of you are ranks, based upon وَلِكُلِّن دَرَجَاتٌ مِمَّا عَمِلُوا. Your deeds, your actions. Not your amani, not your visual thinking. لَيْسَ بِأَمَانِيُكُمْ وَلَا أَمَانِي أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. You have to prove your worth through your deeds and actions. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِلٍ أَمَّا يَعْمَلُونَ And your Lord is not unaware of what they are doing. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَنِيُّ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ And your Lord is self-sufficient. He doesn't need anything. He doesn't need your service. If you serve Him, if you obey Him, well, the benefit is for you, your own self. He doesn't need anything. He doesn't stand in need of anything. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَنِيُّ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ And He is the Lord of mercy. إِنْ يَشَعْ يُذْهِبْكُمْ If He so likes, He can make you perish, all of you, all humans and jinns. He can make you perish, do away with you. وَيَسْتَخْلِفْ مِنْ بَعْدِكُمْ And then He can bring as successors for you مَا يَشَعْ Whatever He will like. كَمَا أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ قَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ As He has raised you from the progeny of a people, other people, who have perished, who had gone. You know, the people of Hud, the nation of Aad, they actually were the remnants of the people of Nuh, alayhi salatu wasalam. From there, they sprang into, and they flourished into a very big nation. In the same way, Thamud, They were a people, a nation, who started from remnants, a few mu'mineen believers, who were saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the whole of the people of Hud, the nation of Aad, was destroyed. So generation after generation, and nations after nation, but there is a possibility in this verse, in this ayah. People who believe that the theory of evolution is compatible with Quran. I don't want to go into this controversy, whether it is correct or wrong, but I want to point out, there have been people and there are people that think that the evolution theory, not the theory of Darwin, evolution is something else, Darwinian theory of evolution, evolution is something else. But essentially evolution is compatible with the teachings of the Quran. Here this ayah can mean, كَمَا أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ قَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ As He has created you, raised you, from another species. A species of animals, from that springs another species. From that another species. And so many species we know have perished. Where are those dinosaurs? Gone. Such big animals. Such giant animals. Gone. You find their skeletons. That means they were there. But they have gone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been producing species from other species. And then the former species, they just vanished. They were destroyed. So it can happen again, this ayah says. They can make you perish and bring another creation in your place. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَآتٍ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ مُوْجِزِينَ Certainly what you are being promised is to come. It will come. Don't have any doubts. Don't harbor any doubts in your minds. It will come. وَمَانْتُمْ مِمُوْجِزِينَ And you won't be able to defeat Allah, to frustrate Allah, to escape from His grift, from His grip. You won't be able to escape. قُلْ يَا قَوْمِ اعْمَلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ إِنِّي عَامِلٌ Now this is a challenge from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know this, I told you these surahs, Suratul Anam as well as Suratul Araf, they were revealed just before Hijrah. You know the conflict between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba Ikram on the one side and you know the pagans and the idolaters of Makkah on the other side, that had reached its zenith. So at this stage the Prophet has been asked to throw an open challenge. قُلْ يَا قَوْمِ مَلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ Say to them, O Muhammad, O my nation, do whatever you can do. Strive the hardest that you can. Strive your utmost to stop me and my dawah and my call. إِنِّي عَامِلْ I'll also strive my best. سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ تَكُونُ لَهُ عَاقِبَةُ الدَّارِ Very soon you will come to know. For whom will be the good end of the eternal abode? إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِعُ الظَّالِمُونَ Certainly, the evil doers are not going to be successful. This is a challenging tone. اعملوا على مكانتكم إني عامل وجعلوا لله مما زرع من الحرث والأنعام نصيبا. Now there are coming three, four things. These were their superstitions. They had a Sharia of their own, concocted, forged. And they said that this has been given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our forefathers. Our forefathers have been doing it, so it is coming from Allah. But a few things regarding their own Sharia. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ مِمَّا ذَرَى مِنَ الْحَرْثِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ نَصِيبًا. And they fixed for Allah also a part of their charity from amongst the crop as well as the animals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them. They believed in Allah, I told you. They were mushriks. They believed in Allah and along with Allah, some other gods. جَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ مِمَّا ذَرَى مِنَ الْحَرْثِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ نَصِيبًا. So they had some part of the charity reserved for Allah. فَقَالُوا هَذَا لِلَّهِ بِزْعَمِهِمْ. And they said, according to their own belief, this is for Allah. This we keep for Allah. وَهَذَا لِشْرَكَائِنَا. And this is for our associate gods. We have to please them also. If they get angry from us, then we will be doomed. Now the most, you know, interesting thing is, فَمَا كَانَ لِشْرَكَائِهِمْ فَلَا يَسِلُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. What they reserve for their associate God, it cannot go towards Allah. It cannot join, it cannot be added to the portion that they have reserved for Allah. وَمَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ فَهُوَ يَسِلُوا إِلَى شُرَكَائِهِمْ. What they had reserved for Allah, it is added to the portion of the associates. سَامَا يَحْكُمُونَ. Very bad and evil what they are doing. Now what was the reason? Although they thought that Allah is bigger, highest, and these gods and goddesses which we are worshipping, they are smaller ones. But you know, they feared the smaller ones more. Because if you take the case of a villager, for example, he knows that there is a head of the state also. But he has never to deal with him. He is dealing with the patwari. You know, the lowest revenue officers or officials, he has to deal with them. They can remit their revenues and etc. and etc. So actually they have to fear them, not the head of the state. There is the head of the state, no doubt, they know. But actually they fear more the lowest, you know, officials. In the same way, although they believed in Allah, but actually they wanted more to please these lower gods, smaller gods. So the portion reserved for their associate gods couldn't go to the portion of Allah, but the portion fixed for Allah could be mixed with that. Second, وَكَذَلِكَ زَيَّنَ لِكَثِيرٍ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ قَتْلَ أَوْلَادِهِمْ شُرَكَاؤُهُمْ. In the same manner, some of their associate gods have made it very beautiful for them to kill their offsprings. They presented their offsprings also as a gift to their gods and goddesses. Just as they are giving some gift to their gods and goddesses from the crop, from the animals. In the same way, killing their offsprings, sons, to please some god or goddess. لَيُرْضُوهُمْ. These associate gods, you know, they are killing their offspring for them so that they make them perish, destroy them. وَلَيَلْبِسُوا عَلَيْهِمْ دِينَهُمْ. And they have made them confused about their religion. What they are doing? وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا فَعَلُوهُ. And had Allah decreed, they couldn't have done so. But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the option, freedom of choice. You have been given this life as a testing period. فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ. So just ignore them. Just leave them alone and what they are forging. All these are forged ideas. There's no, you know, documentary proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them these instructions. وَقَالُوا هَذِهِ third. This is the third superstition. وَقَالُوا هَذِهِ أَنْعَامٌ وَحَرْسٌ حِجْرٌ. And they fixed, you know, some of their animals, cattle and their crops. They are forbidden. They are reserved. لا يطعمها الا من نشاء بزعمهم. You know, from this field or crop, nobody can eat anything except, you know, they had a list of their own. Only they can have these things. And likewise, some of the cattle. وَأَنْعَامٌ حُرِّمَتْ ظُهُورُهَا. And they also fixed some cattle whose backs were forbidden. Forbidden from either, you know, do you go travel on their backs, ride them, or carrying loads? No, these animals, they are dedicated to such and such idols, to such and such gods and goddesses. Now you can't touch them. وَأَنْعَامٌ لَا يَذْكُرُونَ اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا افْتِرَاءً عَلَيْهِ. And then they had fixed certain cattle. We can't take the name of Allah while sacrificing them, because we have, you know, devoted them to such and such gods and goddesses. Now Allah's name cannot be taken. All these things were concocted. افْتِرَاءً عَلَيْهِ. They had concocted these things, invented these things, but then they were saying that these things are from Allah. سَيَجْزِيهِمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will very soon recompense them, reward them, punish them from what concoctions they were doing. وَقَالُوا مَا فِي بُطُونِ هَذِي الْأَنْعَامِ خَالِصَةٌ لِذُكُورِنَا. Another one. And they say that whatever is in the wombs of these cattle, this she sheep or she goats or she cow, قَالُوا مَا فِي بُطُونِ هَذِي الْأَنْعَامِ خَالِصَةٌ لِذُكُورِنَا. It is exclusively for our males. وَمُحَرَّمٌ عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِنَا. And it is forbidden. Our wives cannot take it, cannot eat from it. وَإِنْ يَكُنْ مَيْتَةً. And if it is born dead, فَهُمْ فِيهِ شُرَكَاءَ. Then both of them, males and females, could eat it. سَيَجْزِيهِمْ وَصْفَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will very soon recompense them for all these things, allegations that they have made against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ. Verily, He is all-wise, all-knowing. قَدْ خَسِرَ الَّذِينَ. Now there are the comments on these superstitions of theirs. قَدْ خَسِرَ الَّذِينَ قَتَلُوا أَوْلَادَهُمْ. People who killed their own offsprings to please the idols or gods and goddesses, they have thrown themselves in loss. بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Without any authority, without any knowledge, without any documentary knowledge. وَحَرَّمُوا مَا رَزَقَهُمُ اللَّهِ. They have deprived themselves what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them. Allah had given them a son, a daughter, and they presented it and sacrificed it at the altar of some god and goddesses. افْتِرَاءَ اللَّهِ. And again it is an iftira, a concoction. And they are attributing it to Allah. فَضَّلُّوا وَمَا كَانُوا مُهْتَدِينَ. They have gone astray and they were not the people rightly guided. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَ جَنَّاتٍ مَعْرُوشَاتٍ. And it is He who raised up gardens, supported and unsupported. You know, these trees, these plants of grapes, they are supported. They can't go, they can't stand by themselves. مَعْرُوشَاتٍ وَغَيْرُ مَعْرُوشَاتٍ. And there are other which don't need any support. وَالنَّخْلَ. And the date palm. وَالزَّرْعَ. And the crop yielding different types of مُخْتَلِفًا أُكُلُهُ. Different types of edibles. وَالزَّيْتُونَ. And the olives. وَالرُّمَّانَ. And the pomegranate. مُتَشَابِهًا وَغَيْرَ مُتَشَابِهِ. And they are similar to each other also and different from each other also. كُلُهُ مِنْ سَمَرِهِ. Eat off their fruit is a asmara, when they are bearing fruit. وَآتُوا حَقَّهُ يَوْمَ حَسَادِهِ. And you must pay the due from that on the very day of the harvest. When you have harvested the fruit, on the same day, one-tenth or whatever has been fixed, you give it for Allah, you give it for charity. وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. But don't be extravagant. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. Allah doesn't like the extravagant people. وَمِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ حَمُولَةً وَفَرْشًا. وَمِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ. The words which come in the beginning of the previous ayah, they are implied here also. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَ مِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ حَمُولَةً وَفَرْشًا. And it is He who was raised from among the cattle, hamulatan. The big animals, who are the beasts of burden, they can carry loads, the camel, and the horse, and the mule, etc., etc. Wafarsha, and smaller ones, who are to be slaughtered for, you know, eating. Kulu mimma razaqakum Allah. Go and eat what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطْوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Don't follow in the footsteps of Satan. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Verily, he is for you an open enemy. سَمَانِيَةَ أَزْوَاجٍ. Again the same. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَى سَمَانِيَةَ أَزْوَاجٍ. And it is he who has raised eight in pairs. These were the cattles usually who are being used either for, you know, carrying loads or whose meat or flesh was taken as food. So there are four pairs, eight in total. Eight in pairs. Samaniyat Azwaj. Min al-Za'n isnain, two from the sheep, the he-sheep and the she-sheep. Wa min al-Ma'z isnain, and two from the goat. He-goat, she-goat. Qul az-zakarayn harrama amil unsayayn. Now ask them, whether Allah has declared prohibited the two males or the two females? أَمَّا اشْتَمَلَتْ عَلَيْهِ أَرْحَامُ الْأُسْرَيَيْنِ. Or what? Or he has declared or forbidden, you know, to eat what is contained in the wombs of the two females. نَبْبِعُونِي بِعِلْمٍ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Now tell this to me with knowledge, documented knowledge, knowledge with authority, if you are true in whatever you are thinking, what you are believing. وَمِنَ الْإِبْنِ اسْنَيْنِ. And in the same way, he raised among the camel also two. He camel, she camel. وَمِنَ الْبَقَرِ اسْنَيْنِ. Among the cow, oxen two, male and female. قُلَا زَكَرَيْنِ حَرَمَ أَمِلْ أُنْسَيَيْنِ. Ask them, has Allah declared haram the two males or the two females? أَمَّا اسْتَمَلَتَ عَلَيْهِ أَرْحَامُ الْأُنْسَيَيْنِ. Or he has declared that which is contained in the wombs of the two females. أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءِ إِذْ وَصَّاكُمُ اللَّهُ بِهَذَا. Were you present at that time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you all these things? You say this is something from Allah. Were you present? If you were not present, do you have any documentary proof? Do you have any book? Any book which you claim to be revealed book? You have to bring forth. فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. So who is more evildoer than the one who concocts and forges a lie and attributes it to Allah? لَيُضُلَّ النَّاسَ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. So that to make people go astray without any knowledge. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah is not going to guide such evildoers to the right path. قُلْ لَا أَجِدُ مَا فِي مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ مُحَرَّمًا عَلَى طَاعِمٍ يَطْعَمُهُ. Tell them, say to them, I don't find in whatever is being revealed to me anything prohibited to eat for an eater who is eating it, except illa. Now what are the basic things which have been declared haram by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Illa an yakuna maitatan. Number one exception, an animal is dead, so flesh of this dead animal is haram. أو دم مسفوحا. Or the blood which has been, you know, which has flown out. دم مسفوحا. If very small quantities of blood remains in the body, well, this is not haram. When you have done tazkiya and the maximum blood goes out, still some blood can remain in the body. So that is not haram. Which can be, you know, flown out. أو لحم خنزيرين. Number three, the flesh of the swine. فَإِنَّهُ رِجْسٌ. Because it is foul in itself. فَإِنَّهُ رِجْسٌ. It is in itself foul and impure. أَوْ فِسْقًا. Or the impious meat. وَهِلَّا لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ بِهِ. Of the animal sacrificed for someone else other than Allah. It was a goat. It was a sheep. All okay. Halal, permissible. But it was sacrificed in the name of some other deity, some other god except Allah. Now it has become impious. فَمَنِ اسْتُرَّ غَيْرَ بَاغٍ وَلَا عَادٍ. Even among these things, who is compelled? But two conditions, neither craving for it nor transgressing the limits. فَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. For such people, your Lord is forgiving and merciful. وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ هَادُوا حَرَّمْنَا كُلَّ ذِي ظُفَرٍ. And all those people who became Jews, who called themselves Jews, حَرَّمْنَا كُلَّ ذِي ظُفَرٍ. We had prohibited for them to eat all the animals who have undivided hoofs, just as horse, etc. You know, the hoofs are one, not divided. وَمِنَ الْبَقَرِ وَالْغَنَمِ حَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ شُهُومَهُمَا. And also even from the sheep, as well as the cows and oxen and calves, we prohibited upon them their fat. This fat was haram, except إِلَّا مَا حَمَلَتْ ظُهُورُهُمَا, whatever is sticking to their backs, أَوِلْ حَوَيَا, or with the intestines, mixed, أَوْ مَخْتَلَتَ بِعَظُمْ, or which is mixed with the bones. But there, where there is fat, separate fat, you know, that is haram, that was declared haram for them. ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِبَغْيِهِمْ. But it was a penalty. We had given them this reward and this penalty due to their insolence. They were rebellious. Although this was actually not haram, it was halal, permissible. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared it as a penalty upon them. وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ. And believe, whatever we are telling is correct and true. فَإِنْ كَذَّبُوكَ. Now, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they are belying you, if they are refuting you, فَقُلْ رَبُّكُمْ ذُو رَحْمَةٍ وَعَسِعَةٍ. Tell them, your Lord has very wide mercy. The mercy of your Lord embraces everything. But at the same time, وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَعْسُهُ عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. His punishment will also not be averted from the people who are guilty, who are sinful. So these two aspects of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes must be kept simultaneously in mind. Shadeedul Iqab, Zuntiqab, Rauf and Rahim, and Ghafoor. These two aspects, they must be kept and borne in mind simultaneously. سَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكُوا. Now these people will say, the last argument or the last plea that they can take, سَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكْنَا وَلَا آبَاؤُنَا وَلَا حَرَّمْنَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Now they will say, had Allah willed or wished, we couldn't have associated anything with Him. We are under His control. He is controlling everything. Nor our forefathers could have done this shirk. Nor we had, you know, we could have declared things unlawful without His permission. When it has happened, so it means that it has the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is the Lord, He is the controller, nothing can happen here. You say no leaf can move without His permission. So everything, if it has happened in the past, it has come to pass by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is their argument. كَذَلِكَ كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Such was the argument of the people who were before them. This is the last, you know. They ignore here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given option. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. Every human being, it is open to him. He can go to the right path or to the wrong path. Had this not been there, there was no question of any testing. And then there could be no question of any rewarding or punishing. So this is the basic philosophy. حَتَّى ذَاقُوا بَعْسَنَا. Until they tasted, you know, our punishment and chastisement. قُلْ هَلْ إِنْدَكُمْ مِنْ عِلْمِ. Now this is the counter-attack. Ask them, is with you present any knowledge, any documentary knowledge that you produce? تُخْرِجُوهُ لَنَا. Which you can present before us, that this is the book. Wrongly or rightly, we were told that this is the divine book. And it is written in this book, all these laws. They didn't have any book whatsoever. All were superstitions only. هَلْ عِنْدَكُمْ مِنْ عِلْمٍ فَتُخْرِجُوهُ لَنَا إِن تَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ. No, you are following nothing except your own conjectures. إن أنتم إلا تخرصون. And you are doing nothing except guessing. It's all guesswork. It's all, you know, the creation of your imagination and nothing else. قُلْ فَلِلَّهِ الْحُجَّةُ الْبَالِغَةُ. Now, this argument, you know, tell them, now the argument is in the favor of Allah. If you can't produce any book, any document, now who wins the argument? فَلِلَّهِ الْحُجَّةُ الْبَالِغَةُ. The conclusive argument is now in favor of Allah. فَلَوْ شَاءَ لَهَدَاكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Had he so wished, he could have put all of you on the right path. But you know, he has given you the option. Even now, if you don't believe, well, okay, no, don't believe. Go your way. Well, another alternative. If you don't have any written proof, any documentary proof of what you are saying, there can be another alternative. قُلْ هَلُمَّ شُهَدَاكُمُ الَّذِينَ يَشْهَدُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ هَذَا. Okay. Bring forth the witnesses from amongst you who can testify to it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared these things to be haram. Fine, shahidu. It was hoped that none of them will take this courage. But it is said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fine, shahidu. If suppose someone of them comes, you know, and says, yes, I am a witness to it. La fala tashhad ma'ahum. O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you don't be a witness to it. وَلَا تَتَّبِ أَهْوَالَ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. And you don't follow the wishes and the whims of the people who are denying and belying our revelations. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ وَهُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ يَعْدِلُونَ. And those who are denying the akhirah, the hereafter. This is the real disease. This is the real cause. They love this world. And they want to keep off, keep out of sight, out of mind, the hereafter. If somebody has any idea of resurrection and hereafter and the accountability of the day of judgment, then he will listen. He will be serious. He will ponder over things. But if he is just, you know, carefree, he has no idea. If he absolutely denies that there is going to be a resurrection, then, you know, this is the basic disease. وَهُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ يَعْدِلُونَ. And that is why they are making or declaring other things or other people or other, you know, or other gods and goddesses equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this word yadilun, it appeared in the first ayah also. Alhamdulillah alladhi khalaqa samawati wal ard wa ja'ala sulamati wal noor summa alladhina kafaru bi rabbihim yadilun. Now what does it denote? The main, you know, discussion of this surah has finished here. The beginning and the end, the similarity. Now the rest of the two sections, they are, so to say, the concluding remarks, final remarks. Just, you know, in a sermon, you know, a person who is giving a sermon, he goes to the right, to the left, he deals different aspects of this issue, and then, you know, he comes to the main issue again. So that, you know, the real thing which is to be impressed, it becomes absolutely clear. After all this discussion, now this is the essence. قُلْ قَالَوْ أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come, I tell you, I narrate to you, this is with authority, you know, I narrate to you what your Rabb, your Lord has declared as prohibited for you. You have concocted these beliefs and these ideas and this, you know, your creation of your own imagination and thinking, all these beliefs and rules, etc., etc., having no proof, no documentary proof, no intellectual basis, but now I tell you, what is the real deen? This is the basis of the deen of Allah. And here, if you can count, these are the 10 commandments of Quran. Number one, Allah tushriku billah shaya. Don't associate with Allah as a partner or equal in any respect, neither in his person, nor in his attributes, nor for that matter in his rights, nor for that matter in his authority. Four aspects of shirk. Associating someone in the person of Muhammad, Allah. Associating someone, making declare him equal in some attribute of Allah, in some authority of Allah, in some right of Allah. Number one. Second, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. You have to do good Behave gently to your parents. Number three, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ. Don't kill your offsprings for the fear of poverty. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُمْ وَإِيَّاهُمْ. It's we are providing you also, we shall provide them also. Don't think you are providing for your own self. Provider is Allah. He will provide for them also. Number four, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ. Don't go near the indecencies, the open shameful acts. Don't go near them, whether they are openly done, committed, or secretly. Number five, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Don't assassinate, don't kill, don't murder any human being, any human soul, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared to be haram, illa bilhaq, except in the course of law, in the course of justice. If somebody has killed someone, maybe he is also killed for him. Inna nafsa bin nafsi. But without that, without any cause, you know, not killing any human being. Number six, zalikum wassakum. This is not number six. These five things have been added here. ذَٰلِكُمْ وَسَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these things He has enjoined upon you so that you may think and you may ponder, you may understand that these are the basis of human society and social order. Number six, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا مَالَ الْيَتِيمِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنُ. Don't go near the property of the orphan, but in the best way. Don't try to eat it up before he becomes, you know, he comes of age, he becomes mature. Hatta yablugha ashuddah. Till that time that he reaches his puberty and he becomes a mature person. Number seven, waful kaila wal mizana. Seven and eight. Fill the mayor. When you are mayoring something and you are giving, selling something by mayor, fill the mayor. Wal mizana. And you know, give the full weight. Number eight, bil qist, with justice. La nukallifu nafsan illa wus'aha. We are not going to hold responsible anybody, any soul, except according to his capacity. We are not going to charge anyone, any soul, but according to his capacity. And number nine, وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعَدِلُوا وَلَوْ كَانَ ذَا قُرْبَى. If you say something, if you are giving a verdict in any dispute, then it should be just. Do justice. Although the concerned party might be related to you, but you are not going to be to do any favor, you know. You have to be just. And last but not the least, and you may say, this is the most important, the most comprehensive. وَبِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ أَوْفُوا. And fulfill the covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just recall the first ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفِي بِالْعُقُودِ. Aqd and ahd, they are the same. Aqd and ahd. وَبِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ أَوْفُوا. And all the covenants you have made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfill them. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّابِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined upon you, so that you may be reminded. So actually this is the basis of deen. You have just forgot all these things. Your all malpractices in your dealings with human beings. But you know, you are very sensitive about these things. This animal is haram. I can't ride it. And this is, you know, the flesh of this animal I can't take. And these superstitions, as I told you last night, they haunt the people even after coming to believe. Because they have very deep roots in the subconscious minds of the people, of the nations. We, most of us who have converted to Islam from Indian background, we have still, you know, because they had a belief that a person dies, you know, his soul coming over to the house, doesn't run away for 3 days, then you know you give some charity and then it will run away. So they were doing tija, third day, you know, and we are doing soyam. We just, you know, translated tija into soyam. From Hindi, it was Persian. So actually it's the same thing. The same customs, the same superstitions. But if the poor soul is coming to your house, what it is going to do to you? let it enjoy, you know, the company of the beloveds, the sons and the daughters, and maybe wife, etc., etc. You want to make Imran off. But for you, then you have to feed some people. You know, the clergy, when the religion becomes a profession, they need something to eat, and the best things to be, you know, offered in eating. And this is what happens everywhere. So these are the things, you know, they haunt the nations even after they have changed their creeds, they have changed their beliefs. But these things, you know, they have deep roots into their subconscious mind, into their psyche. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا. And declare, O Muhammad, this is my path, which is very straight. These 10 things, you know, 10 commandments of Torah are very important. And here I have counted for you 10 commandments of Quran. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. This is my path, which is absolutely straight, so follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. And don't follow other paths. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. They will scatter you away from the path of Allah. This is the only path. اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. We ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every rak'ah of our prayer, اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا. This is my path, the straight path. فَاتَّبِعُوا وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined upon you so that you may have real taqwa. So that you may be saved from the fire of hell. So actually, this is for you. You are to benefit this, from this, you know, not that Allah needs something. ثُمَّ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ تَمَامًا عَلَى الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ. And then we gave the book to Moses also. It was to fulfill all the person and to complete for the person who wanted to do good, whosoever wants to go on the right path. Torah was a guide to him, but tafsir al kulli shay, and all details were discussed in that. Wahudan, and it was a guidance. Warahmatan, and a mercy. لَعَلَّهُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ. So that they should believe in the meeting with Allah. Now this is most crucial. This akhirah, this returning towards Allah. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. This is most fundamental. If we have the belief in it, then we shall be very serious regarding all the things. We'll think twice before doing something. What will happen on the Day of Judgment? I have to go and meet my Lord. And I have to stand before Him. أَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَاوَىٰ. Who has been fearing that a day has to come. There'll be an hour, the fixed hour, the appointed hour, as-sa'ah, when I'll be resurrected. And I'll have to stand before my Lord for the grand accountability of the Day of Judgment. If this fear is there, he, you know, his behavior will be okay. He will think twice before even uttering a word. Will I be able to justify this word on the Day of Judgment before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I could say this? وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. And now after Moses, whom we gave Torah, this is the book that we have sent down. هَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. It's most profound. It can bring all the good which is inherent in your nature, bring forth. It will just as the water, you know, from the rain water, can bring forth the hidden treasures of the earth. In the same way, the hidden treasure within you, the divine soul within you, the divine spark, as some of the Western philosophers use this term, divine spark in man. There is a divine spark. So that divine spark of within you, it can bring it forth, it can develop it. So this is the book, most profound. هَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. Follow it now. وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And have taqwa of Allah. Try to save yourself from His displeasure so that you can be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does mercy upon you. Antakulu, this is a very important ayah. Just as we had, you know, the people of the book were addressed. Antakulu, lest you should say on the Day of Judgment that no Bashir and no Nazir came to us. No. 600 years passed. No Bashir, no Nazir came to us. Now, فَقَدْ جَاكُمْ بَشِيرٌ وَنَزِيرٌ. In the same way, the pagan Arabs are here addressed. أَنْ تَقُولُوا إِنَّمَا أُنزِلَ الْكِتَابُ عَلَىٰ طَائِفَتَانِ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا. Lest you should say that the book was given and sent to two parties before us. The book was given to the Jews, Torah. Another book was given to the Christians, Injil. We were not given any book. So that could be the basis of a plea that you can take on the Day of Judgment. وَإِنْ كُنَّا عَنْ دِرَاسَتِهِمْ لَغَافِلِينَ. We were not aware of their teachings and their, you know, readings and learnings. We were a different nation. They were a different nation. Book was given to them. They are accountable. But we were not given any book. So we are not accountable. أَنْ تَقُولُوا إِنَّمَا أُنزِلَ الْكِتَابُ عَلَىٰ طَائِفَتَيْنِ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا وَإِنْ كُنَّا عَنْ دِرَاسَتِهِمْ لَغَافِلِينَ أَوْ تَقُولُوا أَنَّا لَوْ أَنَّا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا الْكِتَابَ لَكُنَّا أَهْدَى مِنْهُمْ. Or you might say on the Day of Judgment that had the book been given to us, we would have been much more rightly guided than they. You can say it. Because you know it's a conditional sentence. Had the book been given to us, we wouldn't have proved to be like Jews or the Christians, that they didn't fulfill their obligations toward that book. If it was given to us, we would have been ahda, more rightly guided than them. فَقَدْ جَاكُمْ بَيَّنَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. You know, the possibility of all these pleas and all these lame excuses finished when this book has come to you. Now the bayyana has come to you from your Lord. And what is bayyana? Just recall the first ayah of Surah Al-Bayyana. لَمْ يَكُنِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ مُنْفَكِّينَ حَتَّى تَاتِيَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَا. And what is bayyana? رَسُولٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُو صُحُفًا مُطَهَّرَةً فِيهَا كُتُبٌ قَيِّمَةً. So this bayyana has now come to you. This bayyana had come to the Bani Israel, to the sons of Israel. This bayyana had come to the Christians or the Jews. Actually, Hazrat Masih was also sent for the Jews, basically. So this bayyana came to them. You could have said, well, no bayyana came to us. How are we being accounted against? No. فَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَهُدًى and the guidance, وَرَحْمَةً and the mercy. فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. So now, who is more evildoer than the one who belies the revelations of Allah? Instead of accepting them, benefiting from them, following them, they are belying, refuting, rejecting. وَصَرَفَ عَنْهَا. And they are turning away from them. سَنَجْزِ الَّذِينَ يَصْرِفُونَ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا سُوَ الْعَذَابِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْرِفُونَ. Very soon we shall put these people who are turning away from our revelations due to this turning away to a very bad, a very grievous punishment we shall give to them. هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. Now what are they waiting for? All the things have been made clear to them. All their objections have been cleared. All arguments have been given to them. Everything has been clarified. Now what are they waiting for? Why are they not accepting this book of Allah and accepting Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. Are they waiting for the angels to come? أَوْ يَاتِيَ رَبُّكُ. Or they are waiting for the Lord to come himself? Now just recall here the ayah of Surah Al-Fajr. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. On the Day of Judgment, surely, Allah will also descend. And you know, all the malaika will be standing over there in the divine court, you know. There will be the Chief Justice of the Day of Judgment, Maliki Yawmi Deen, he will be there before the eyes. So actually, are they waiting for the Day of the Judgment? These words mean this. هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ رَبُّكَ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ بَعْضُ آيَاتِ رَبِّكَ. Or some signs of your Lord come. Now these signs, you know, have been given by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his prophecies. Signs of Qiyamah. Alamatu Sa'ah. You can find full chapters in the books of Ahadith, you know, under this title. When those signs of Qiyamah, clear signs will come, then, you know, it will not be possible for anybody to benefit from Iman. Now the doors will be closed. Yawma yati ba'du ayati rabbik. The day when you know these signs from your Lord will come to you. La yanfa'u nafsan imanuha lam takun amanat min qabl. Now no soul will be able to benefit from Iman, from believing at that time, who had not believed before. Aw kasabat fi imaniha khaira. Or who had not earned any good deeds in his beliefs. Only believing means nothing. Unless you are doing also good deeds. Wal asri innal insana lafi khusr. إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. قل انتظروا. Again the same challenging attitude. So okay, go on waiting. إنا منتظرون. We are also waiting. Now we shall see which way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to decide. إن الذين فرقوا دينهم وكانوا شيعا. Verily those who have split up their deen, divided their deen, and they have become sects. لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ. Oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you don't have to do anything with them. Because they have divided their deen. You know what happened? Deen was Islam. Deen of Ibrahim, Islam. But you know the Jews took away a branch. Now this is Judaism. Again the deen of Islam coming. The Christians took a branch to the other side. This becomes Christianity. This deen of Islam has now been perfected on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we found in the last surah, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا فتفرق بكم عن سبيله. Now people who have separated their ways from this right path, now oh Muhammad, you have to do nothing with them. إلى الله إنما أمرهم إلى الله. Their matter is with Allah. He will decide. ثم ينبئهم بما كانوا يفعلون. And then he will inform them what they were doing. من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها. Whosoever will bring a good deed on the day of judgment, he will be given tenfold in reward. وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ. And whosoever brings a bad deed, فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا. He will not be punished but equal to that one good bad deed. وَهُمْ لَا يُسْلَمُونَ. They will not be wronged. قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Now this is, you know, a very beautiful ayah. Proclaim, O Muhammad, and let us also proclaim in the same tone and in the same way. Innani hadani rabbi ila siratin mustaqim. Certainly my Lord has guided me to the right path, to the straight path. Deenan qiyamam millata Ibrahim hanifa. The straight deen. And that is the creed of Ibrahim, who was absolutely free from all shirk, very pure and upright person. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He was not from among the associators. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Proclaim again, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and proclaim each one of you, O Muslims, that my prayers as well as my sacrifices, and in the same way my life and my death, all are devoted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds. قُلَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْغِي رَبًّا. And now a searching question. Do you want me that I should seek another Lord instead of Allah? قُلَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْغِي رَبًّا وَهُوَ رَبُّ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. And He is the Lord. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Nobody, there is no associate with Him. And to this I have been commanded. And I am the first of all who submit to Him. قُلَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْغِي رَبًّا. Tell them, ask them, do you want me to seek another Lord except Allah? وَهُوَ رَبُّ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. He is the Lord of everything. لَا تَقْسِبُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ لَا عَلَيْهَا. All the souls are earning whatever they are earning. They are not earning except on their own themselves. وَلَا تَذِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. And no soul will carry the load of another soul. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ مَرْجِعُكُمْ. Then to your Lord is going to be your return. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. And then He will tell you and He will inform you in what things you had been differing. وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَكُمْ خَلَائِفَ الْأَرْضِ. And it is He who made you the successors and vicegerents in the earth. وَرَفَعَ بَعْضَكُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ. And He raised you over some others. some of you or the others in ranks. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِي مَا آتَاكُمْ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ, so that he may test you, he may try you, he may put you to test in what he has given you. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ سَرِيُّ الْعِقَابِ, verily your Lord is very swift in reckoning, in taking the account, and swift in giving the punishment. وَإِنَّهُ لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, and verily and certainly he is غَفُور, forgiving, and رَحِيم, merciful. Again the two aspects, the attributes of Allah, he is سَرِيُّ الْعِقَابِ and he is غفور الرحيم. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.